welcome you to today's show and ask those of you who have not subscribed to please subscribe to our YouTube channel as we continue to expose the satanic Illuminati agenda and the ushering in of the Antichrist. We also ask those of you who have not subscribed to our backup channel to pause it now. Please go over there, click the link in the description box below or in the comment section. Subscribe over there. We already have a strike on this channel. So if you enjoy the channel, I recommend subscribing to the backup channel. Today's show, I want to expose another blatantly obvious Illuminati symbol. That is the symbol you see, the Baphomet, the goat that these people worship, the goat with breasts and a penis that these lunatics worship and bow down to. The hand gesture that he does is pointing up with one hand, his right hand, pointing down with the other hand, his left hand. That is known as above, so below. It is seen commonly all over the place. It's a pose and a thing you have to look for that you might not realize what they're doing. It is a well-known slogan in witchcraft and in Satanism. And the Emerald Tablet, which is a magical document that the Satanists and the witches hold in high regard. It's part of Western occultism. The opening lines of the Emerald Tablet read, "True without falsehood, certain and most true, that which is above is the same as that which is below, and that which is below is the same as that which is above for the performance of miracles of the one thing. And as all things are from the one by the meditation of one, so all things have their birth from this one thing by adaptation." So you'll see celebrities doing this. You see Lady Gaga doing it. It doesn't always have to be with the one finger up and the one finger down. Sometimes, like Madonna, on one of her album covers, she does the 666 up and the 666 below. You see Quentin Tarantino doing the devil horns up and the devil horns down. It's paying homage to the Baphomet. It's part of the craft. It's part of what these people believe in. You could see the same as above, so below mentality in a lot of other symbols, such as the yin-yang symbol. You also see the as above, so below symbolism with reflections on water. So what they do is they build these monuments, which are really satanic and demonic, such as the Washington Monument, which, if please listen closely, is 555 feet tall, which is 6,660 inches tall. 55.5 feet wide, which is 666 inches, okay? Because I say this in a lot of videos, and people don't listen, because then they go and they Google the Washington Monument, and they see it's 555, and they go, "You're lying, why are you making stuff up?" It's inches. Convert the feet into inches, okay? It is 666. It is deliberately done. The shaft is what it represents. Ball shaft is what the Washington Monument represents. But you'll see the water below, it's supposed to reflect off of it. No different than what you see at the One World Trade Center now. Okay, this tower, which is, you know, obviously we all know what occurred on September 11th and who was behind it. They built these, the Trade Center obviously is a satanic monument. You could see the pyramid in it. Okay, you can see the straight pyramid, and then the other part is the upside down pyramid, and it reflects off of these pools that they have right next to it. That is the as above, so below mentality. They leave their calling card, so to speak, at some of these events that they do, like September 11th, as well as in Oklahoma City, the memorial that they have outside the Oklahoma City buildings. You'll see a huge lake there. Okay, and it reflects off of a building on the other side, which has a giant pyramid at the top of the building. So these kinds of things you'll find all around, monuments that are, you know, erected by them, famous monuments all around the world, not just in the United States. There was actually a statue of George Washington doing this exact pose. It used to be at the U.S. Capitol building, I believe. And they had to remove it. That was because a George Washington shirt was off, I guess, was the reason that they removed it. But maybe they were just hiding because they didn't want to be too obvious, or somebody would say, "What does this pose represent?" And then connect it to the Baphomet, because obviously they want to keep as much of this stuff hidden as they possibly can. You also see the pose on tarot cards. The tarot card, the magician, which I've talked about on this channel when we were exposing the symbol for the infinity symbol, how it's above this magician's head. During this ritual that he's performed, you can see the magician card and the tarot set of cards, whatever these things are that these Satanists and witches use. You could see him doing the symbol as well, the as above, so below. The hexagram is also looked at as above, so below, because it's the two interlocking triangles, two interlocking pyramids put together. The hexagram is used in witchcraft and Kabbalah and all forms of black magic and Satanism. The hexagram also, interestingly enough, has 6 points on the outside, 6 points on the inside, and 6 pyramids around it, if you take a look at it that way, which is used extensively in black magic and witchcraft. New Age channeling that these cults do. So it's used in Satanism. The as above, so below, like I said, you'll see celebrities doing it. You'll see even just the as above, so below reflections too on album covers and stuff. You see Kanye West on magazine cover with the reflection. You'll see Lady Gaga openly doing it. You'll see P. Diddy openly doing it on the red carpet. Yes, there's a human being with the name P. Diddy walking the earth. It's unbelievable. Some of the names that these false idol Satanists have. It's also important to note that the Sumerian demon Pazuzu, who is one of the first idols worshipped by these cults, also is doing the as above, so below in his statue, as you can see. So the as above, so below, as in heaven, so on earth, as above, so below, three fingers up, three fingers down is what the Baphomet's doing. It's the two fingers and then the thumb out. And like I said, you could see a lot of these celebrities doing it on the red carpet, doing it on magazine covers. Okay, it happens all the time. Lady Gaga, like I said, Katy Perry, Kanye West, P. Diddy, all of them. Movie covers, you'll see it on. So try to look for this symbol. Quentin Tarantino, like I said, doing the devil horns up and down. It doesn't necessarily have to be the three fingers like the Baphomet's using, pointing up and pointing down. You also see him doing it with the 666. And like I said, this is important to look for all the time because it's not just going to be with celebrities on the red carpet. You're going to see monuments placed around the world that are always going to be put, especially obelisks, are going to be put next to a large amount of water, a large still water, you know, like a 2 feet of water that doesn't move, that's flat and stays still, so that the reflection is always there. The reflection is coming from whatever is standing above it. So in this case, the Washington Monument, like I talked about, which is 666, or the Twin Towers, or the One World Trade Center. And if you've ever wondered why, you know, if you've ever gone to any of these monuments and said, well, why is there a body of water? You probably never even thought about it, right? You never probably were like, oh, this is beautiful. They put this water here. It's nice. It's peaceful. It's a park. It's deliberately there. They put it there. They mark it there. Obviously, most of the time, they're putting it there to let you know that they were involved in what occurred, like Oklahoma City, or in, you know, the One World Trade Center, or in Washington, where they just want you to know flat out that this is their, you know, homage to the Baphomet, as above, so below, as in heaven, will be on earth. So keep an eye out for stuff like that when you go, you know, to anywhere. If you go to any public place, you know, any park, if you go to any famous, you know, monuments in your country that you live in, you know, whether it's the Washington Monument, like I said, or it's something in another country in London, you know, they have it all around the world. They have this reflection with the water that they use to give this as above, so below reflection. And that's why it's there. So if you never questioned it before, remember, you have to start questioning everything because all of this stuff is strategically done. Wasn't there some architect that got hired and said, I'd love to, below the Washington Monument, don't you think it'd be great if we had this huge pool that had to be long enough so it could completely reflect it? People can't swim in it, but it'll be nice, right? And people are just, you know, they don't think. They just say, oh, isn't that nice? Somebody designed this and people flip coins in it and make a wish. I mean, you really have to start questioning every single thing you see, especially something that takes a lot of money and a lot of effort and is considered a monument or an attraction because they are behind all of this stuff and there's meanings behind all of it. They don't do anything randomly. They strategically do everything. They are always paying homage to Satan, to the Baphomet. They're always paying homage to the things that they believe. They're doing it in plain sight. These are just things that people aren't trained to question because their brains don't work that way. They just randomly see things and say, oh, that's nice. Somebody must have just designed that. Hey, who designed that? Oh, if this infamous architect just went through this. Oh, he went to Harvard and he figured all. Oh, and he's just wonderful, isn't he? Isn't this great that we have this pool here reflecting all of this stuff off of it? Huh? I mean, come on, what do you think it's there for? It's there because they strategically planned it. They are behind it, as above, so below. That's why it's there. That's what they believe in. And our entire world is surrounded by their symbols. You know, we are surrounded by witchcraft and occultic symbolism everywhere. And people, you know, these Satanists and these witches, I'm telling you, like, they're on me. They're probably getting on other truthers. They're getting a little worried because people are starting to wake up and question things now. They know the beliefs behind this stuff and why it's there. They can't figure out how people haven't figured it out to this point. You know, how dumbed down society is. Some of them are just laughing, scratching their heads, going, wow, people really don't question a thing. I mean, we could tell them that the whole world has Zika and needs to go get a vaccination and we'll really give them cancer there because that's probably what they're planning on doing, right? They can just make anything up and everybody goes along with it, just like your flu shot, right? Everybody's got to get the flu shot. because they tell you got to get the flu shot. Meanwhile, people still get the flu with the flu shot. Yet the next year, they'll go back and get the flu shot again anyway. I mean, that's the kind of society that we live in. That's why we have to start questioning everything and observing everything. We can't let ourselves constantly go into an alpha state. When you go to bed, let yourself slip into one and fall asleep and relax. But during the day, when you're out, when you're doing things, stay aware and awake and look at stuff. Look at the symbols, because they are everywhere. It was Confucius who once said, signs and symbols rule the world, not words nor laws. And that's exactly what's going on. That is exactly the world we're living in. So this is the as above, so below. Look for it. Also look for it in reflections. Okay, things that you, when you see duality and all that stuff, that's exactly what they're doing. That's exactly what they believe in. So keep your eye out for this stuff. I hope you found this informative. I thank you for listening to today's show. Again, if you haven't subscribed to the Backup Channel, please do so. God bless all of you and your families. May peace be with you.